how did you get yourself into the wrong marriage now? How did you? Because from where you started from, it was not.
So you need in your marriage.
And then maybe after a year, 2 years, 3 years, now it's wrong.
No, don't come from Mario, but that don't know actually.
What happened?
No, what he meant
around there.
Come in, what did you are in your devil?
Because probably,
yeah,
maybe both of you has missed something that you need to improve on.
Where will you want Mario when body will give mama no beer?
To serve the marriage.
Where will I know my bed?
There might be something you need to do.
Where will you give more time no beer?
Serve the marriage.
Where you bed?
Okay, maybe a wrong. You, it's true, you have to walk out. It is wrong.
Walk out. Because if not, it can cost your life. So, is it wrong in a way that
there is violence? Are you in a physical warfare? Always, you're not getting along with each other. It would be better you walk out just to save your life. Okay? But, what are the procedures you took to get you finally into that? Have you had time to go through premarital counseling? Have you had time to talk to your spiritual leaders? Your father? As this problem that you want to run away from here, from now, is happening, have you had time to share with your spiritual leaders? And what are they saying? Because I think they should be able to know what is happening. And if there's a way to help, they will be able to help you. But I think yesterday Bishop was addressing some things that are very critical if you were there. The future of your marriage should be designed from the beginning. As you are beginning to enter into it.
Do you
want to marry because you can change the person? According to your feeling, come to our church, pray for our church. I don't know if you are a mindset that will change the person. From among the Canaanite women. Do not marry for my son a wife from among the
Canaanite women.
Yet if you hear the story of Canaan, it's a good land that flows with milk and honey.
You
probably think the ladies there are beautiful. But this one is saying no, don't marry from my son from there. But you go back to our land, pick from my kindred. That means it's looking at the pattern of faith. If you marry someone who is not from your faith, they don't believe in what you believe. They don't believe in the God you believe. And you're forcing them. Eventually, they will cause you these kind of problems. But of course, I don't think it's right to stay in a marriage that will take your life. That's my own opinion. I think we should have something better.
Number one, we need to define why it is wrong marriage. What are the criteria that you define the marriage is wrong? Number two, we need to understand the conflict in that marriage. That once we understand, help me put this side, I want to see the faces. Once we understand how the conflict is in marriage, then we realize who are the parties, because there are two parties in that marriage. Number three, we must ask this question. When you are making choices in your morning, were you attracted to the beauty or you married something like money or resources? Because if we don't define this background, you may say the marriage is wrong while you are the one who is wrong. Number four, before you conclude it is wrong, you must bring in a third party who can help you to address the matter. And then I give you these few points here to assess your marriage. Number one, do you share your secrets together? That means when you share your secret, it includes up your account. How you spend money. Who are your friends? Number two,
Mario,
do you believe in one another? Because the scripture says a believer cannot walk together with an unbeliever. It is not the one in faith, but this is in your own marriage, in your own home. Number three, your faith, both of you, do you come from the same faith background? Number four, who is the third party in your marriage? It can be alcohol, who is the third party? Am I talking to young people? It can be alcohol. It can be your relatives, friends. Who are the one causing that? And then number five, that is a tribal, which is a ratio. Are you all Acholi or you're from different tribes? Which brings up culture difference. And then number six, do you have time together? Oh, you're working in Barara.
No, India is Barara.
And then the wife is working in Toronto. The family is here.
Can no don't can.
I'm showing you red lights.
I think you did my pakwa.
Number seven.
Where are you?
Are both in-laws around you? Both in-laws. Oh, you the young man, you are living with your in-laws. That means you have become Moses, so you will be the shepherd of the cows of the in-laws. Another point. Do you pray together? Oh, when you're praying, this one turns the back, the other one turns the other side. And you pray quietly. Another point, the red card. Do you know your spouse desires? What kind of food he or she eats? When you ask me now, what does mama love the most? I will tell you. You ask her, she will tell you. When you ask mama, what does she hate?
about me.
She will tell you, and when you ask me, I will even tell you
that.
When you ask me, what do I hate when Mama does? I will tell you when you ask her, she knows. That means knowing your spouse. Another red light. Lack of knowledge of knowing our roles in marriage. When you don't know, these are matters that create major conflicts. Thank you.
What?